Thank you, Ian. Hi, my name is Vincent, and today I'll quickly take you through the work that I've been working on during my XP and that I've now continued into my PhD. Quick background, why am I looking into Bentos-coupled demonstrators? When we look at wind turbines over the past decade and a half, two decades, they've gotten bigger and bigger. Now, larger wind turbines can capture more energy, which helps us keep the cost of energy down, but at the same time, these larger blades suffer significantly under gust and fatigue loads. And in the past, we've countered this by using more efficient materials, stepping from metal blades to composite blades, but there's a limit to how much more we can gain from material efficiency, so we need to start looking at load alleviation. And Bentos coupling is one such approach to load alleviation, where if we can design a blade such that when it is deflected upwards, it also twists, we can reduce the aerodynamic angle of attack, hence reducing the aerodynamic loading. Now, this technique is well known in literature. However, there have only been sort of a very limited set of demonstrators, which means there's not a lot of data available to validate our modeling against. And because we are utilizing a new kind of elastic coupling to achieve this, it's very important that we critically assess our modeling approaches. So my work is kind of divided into four main areas. And during the XP, I focus mainly on design and analysis, where in order to achieve this Bentos coupling, we have to step away from traditional quasi-isotropic laminates and fiber angles. And so we're kind of breaking a lot of design rules that have previously been set. So we need to kind of figure out how to best design these new structures. And from an analysis point of view, we're inducing new effects, and certain things such as draping become more pronounced. So we need to more actively integrate that into our analysis procedures. Towards the future, I'll be continuing to develop my design analysis techniques, but I'll also be looking into manufacturing and testing, because the use of these non-standard fiber angles and layups means that certain effects like thermal warping potentially are going to become more pronounced and more key in the performance of the blade. And as well from a testing perspective, because this behavior is now coupled, how we test and load our structures will need to be reevaluated. If you have any questions about the work that I've done or I will be doing, please come find me at my poster, and I'll be more than happy to answer any questions. Thank you.